Folks, my fourth point of the statistical case against Biden, laying out the by the numbers, the improbability of the results as we are told to accept them right now. These results demand further investigation and audit because, in part, because of this improbability. Let's consider my fourth point, which is the absence of actual vetting of mail-in vote. In states like Pennsylvania, where the governor changed the rules by himself, unilaterally, unconstitutionally and illegally decided election procedures, knowing full well that there would be such a mass of mailed-in ballots that there would be no way that election officials could properly vet the legality and validity of these votes. So what happened? In Pennsylvania, the rejection rate of mailed-in ballots was only 0.03%. Okay, now that is 1/30th of the normal rate in the state of Pennsylvania. And mind you, for first-time voters, the typical failure rate is 3%. So 100 times higher than the rejection rate in Pennsylvania. New York, right next door, when they went to large-scale mail-in voting for their primary, they had a rejection rate of 21%. That is 700 times higher than what we saw in Pennsylvania. The point here is that very, very likely, many, perhaps thousands, tens of thousands of these ballots in Pennsylvania are not valid, are not legitimate, but they were not scrutinized. This is another statistical reason for us to seriously audit and review all of these results in these battleground states.